I love you.
Guns and the swords, and then you have weapons of very strange look, and this came to me from two sources. First, I must tell there is a website. I am citing this website many times in my Hull Korea Times website. This website is a blog, actually, a Sai Baba follower, and he interviewed Jas Bahadur Baiba about Rambong John very long ago. I think it must have been something like 2006-7. That time already, Jas Bahadur Baiba told the reporter that, or the blog owner, that Bong John is actually the Maitreya. He will be the Maitreya Buddha of the future. He will be the future Buddha. And that he knows everything about all the secrets, I mean, just Bahadur Baiba, but he had vowed not to disclose the secrets, when and how and what will happen in the future with Rambong John, what is his plan. And then Jas Bahadur Baiba told one thing which is very interesting, you should check it out. I think governments should check it out, because he is writing that Bong John is in the possession of some kind of weapon, some kind of device. Jas Bahadur Baiba didn't use the word device, but it sounds like he's in possession of something which could render all the weapons of the world useless. So, no one really noticed this sentence, and people probably thought this could have been some just exaggeration, and maybe someone was thinking, probably he was thinking some psychic power.
Mission to save the world. We can teach you special powers.
Personal power.
Psychic power.
Past life connection. Telekinesis.
Okay, we, for the last 12 years, we are used to brainwash ourselves with what we see in the internet and hear, that Rambong John is a meditator and he's not a materialist, and he has nothing to do with guns, weapons, violence. But to understand the truth about him, we should be more open-minded and just accept that Bong John is not a meditator, simply not. He played this meditation game because he has fantastic self-control, but he's not a peacemaker, and he's not a spiritual religious person. I know, because I was there as his victim. So anyway, think what you want to think, but to understand what is he planning, you should consider, at least consider and give a thought to these strange elements. Why would he need to render all the weapons of all the world if he's a peace loving and peacemaking Buddha Maitreya, as his followers are saying? So why a Maitreya and why a Buddha? Ramana Maharishi or Ananda Mahima or any holy man, they were never dealing about weapons. Actually, weapons and spiritual path is two very different things. Gautama Buddha could have, he was trained as a soldier, as a Kshatriya soldier, and still he left his Kshatriya, his army, army weapons and army clothes and army dress, and he became a Buddha who just left all these materialistic and violence part of the human life. But Bong John is the opposite. He started like a Lama, but he is more and more getting violent, aggressive, criminal, and brutal. And he even announced in 2011, in front of many people, it's not a secret, that now I can even kill. So, okay, what kind of attainment? And as if it sounded like all these years from 2005, when he was hardly meditating, he was just aiming into a certain level of psychic attainment where he is already allowed to kill, which I don't know about in any shastra, any sutra, and no religion speaks about any kind of spiritual attainment when a person can kill. Because we, anyway, I don't want to go into philosophies. So this is this weapon in the possession of Ram Bomjon, which is supposedly able to render all the weapons of the world useless. And you would not think too much about this sentence if, and I got an email in 2012, after I was already victimized by Bomjon, from an Indian follower who used to be extremely devoted to him. We were friends, online friends, I have never met him, just because we both were like more through Hinduism and yoga, and we were extremely devoted to Bomjon, me too. So this boy, I don't want to tell his name because he would have problems, but I tell his initial, it's R. And I didn't get his approval to tell his name in this video, actually. But he wrote me an email that after I was victimized, and they told him lies about my case, and he believed it for quite a long time. They told that I was mentally ill, and it's not true what I am saying that they did to me, that, and there is a conspiracy of the media against Bomjon. They want to destroy him, so they created this story about me, and on and on. And so Bomjon those times told his followers that they are not allowed to, they are banned to contact me and speak with me and write emails to me. So if you were a very fanatic follower of him, then you just took his order, and no, they didn't contact me. So R didn't contact me for a long time. And he came to Halkoriya in 2013. It was already other ashrams, Sarlahi, Patarkot, and Sindhupalchok. And he was staying with Bomjon, traveling in his cars together with him as his nearest person. And even he stayed very near to his residences. And the thing why he started to have doubts is not because he would know the truth about my case. I still didn't make my website that time, probably, or he was not allowed to read it. No, I already had the website, but he was not reading it because there was the ban by Bomjon to read my websites. But when he started to have doubts was when he saw Bomjon having so many girlfriends and having this Deepshika with sleeping in his residence, and then he saw Deepshika pregnant, and then he saw that Deepshika is again not pregnant, she went for abortion, and then again another girl is pregnant. So all these things started to make him like giving questions if this is really that divine avatar that he thought that Bomjon was. But then he was speaking with his young lamas, not that he was researching, but he made friends with his young lamas, which were also his nearest helpers and assistants and servants, actually, in near his residence. And one young lama told him that he saw a very strange device near Bomjon, and he was trying to, it was a weapon, they knew it was a weapon, that it was like told to the lamas that this is a weapon, this will be used. But this device, he didn't know, probably not to how to say either he had no technical skills or it was just such a weird device that he could not switch it on, and he was just looking from side to side, I can imagine. And what is this? He was saying, very strange, and he shared this. That young lama also had doubts, of course. No, children are children, but some children, even if they are brainwashed, can start to have doubts around Bomjon. And this young lama probably had, and he shared his doubts with R from India, the follower, and he described him this device. And so I have my own experience during the captivity of 2012, but I'm so scared to share these secrets with what I have seen and heard in 2012. I'm telling a lot, but I cannot tell the core of all, because I know that this is Bomjon's main secret, and I'm just scared because no one is holding him yet, no one is questioning him, police is not investigating him, so I cannot feel safe. And he would be, of course, extremely revengeful when I share his main secret, how he is going to destroy people. So, Jasbahadur Vaibha is another source, the Sai Baba web's blog is another source about the weapons. My own experience with shooting, he has guns, rifles, swords, and another source, when I visited his family after I was already victimized, his mother and in his family house in Bongjor, there was a relative of Bomjon visiting. He is not staying in Bomjor, and he told me that he had just come from Bomjon's new ashram. It was in Sindhuli that time, and he told he himself started to have doubts, and of course after he heard the story of Bomjon's own family members being kidnapped and tortured, then he rejected Bomjon's claims to be divine and spiritual. And he told me when he was in Sindhuli that there was some kind of like table, like a long table, and there were dozens of guns. But in the open, like all Bomjon's lamas, monks, followers, nuns know about it and they saw it, it was not even secret. This is just a normal thing for Bomjon's followers to have guns. But obviously this family member of Bomjon, and until that time even follower, devotee, he was shocked. What's this? This is not about peace. What are these many guns doing? Yes, and now I have another proof. Ivan Stankovic, Bomjon's former website, official website's administrator, he was in touch with me for some time, and he was Bomjon's near person, and he was staying near him many times when he visited him in Nepal as one of the elite members. And he was in contact with Kim Nguyen, another nearest person and donor and of Bomjon, and Ivy Jugoa and Joan Stanley Baker, Andrea Good. There was this elite group of Bomjon's trusted foreigners, trusted because they had money and they were ready to lie. But Ivan was not really ready to lie. As soon as he started to see that there are many things he had to cover up and lie, then he started to question. And one strange thing that he was told by Bomjon's, like there were whispering things, the elite of Bomjon, the highest elite of the foreigners, they had their own newsletter, insider newsletter, which of course you, the large public followers, they never saw those emails. These are like a small circle of newsletters, and in these insider newsletters many secrets of Bomjon had been exchanged. And when Ivan was still, he of course kept these old emails, and when he was still a follower, so he received an email because some foreign elite member was present when this happened, and it was also like full of doubts and confusing. So what happened actually, Deepshikha Bomjon's wife got fed up by Bomjon having so many girlfriends. And it was sometimes a bit before the earthquake. So she was still not pregnant, or she was pregnant and she was aborting the children regularly. But in the same time, Bomjon was having girlfriends, sleeping with them in the same house. And so she was so fed up. So at one point she took a rifle, and it's written in the email, she took a rifle and turned it to her own head. She went to the yard, like the public area of Bomjon's ashram, so all the lamas and monks and nuns could see her. And she was ready to make suicide in front of everyone. And I don't know if she was raising her voice, but she was telling Bomjon that if you are not stopping to have girlfriends, then I will shoot myself. And this moment when she was threatening Bomjon to kill herself, allegedly, but we don't know that this is not really true, but allegedly, at least temporarily, stopped Bomjon to have girlfriends in such an open way. Okay, so the story is heartbreaking because everyone is, Deepshikha is a nice person. I personally met her, and no one was ever against Deepshikha. I don't think she ever harmed anyone. There are interesting things described by the rape victim Ganga Maya, but she wanted only to hide Bomjon's crimes of raping the nun, but threatening her to be killed if she speaks out. But okay, Deepshikha didn't. Deepshikha is also suffering, I wanted to say, and obviously every woman who must see that her husband is having many other girls, then every such woman must suffer. So even Ivan liked Deepshikha, and they felt heartbroken that she even wanted to make suicide. But what is shocking to me most, no one is questioning why Deepshikha, what is doing a gun? I mean, gun or rifle, it was not detailed, in the residence of the biggest avatar of the highest, I don't know what, Maitreya and Kalki and Messiah, Rambhadur Bomjon, as his followers are considering him, who claims that he is going to bring peace to the world, and he wants to end all wars and violence, and he is the main preacher of non-violence in Nepal. So what is a gun doing in his residence? Yes, then you are telling his followers like Mani Lama, Kamal Singh Lama, and Dev Kota, these Kathmandu followers who are actually entwined into the political elite of Nepal. So they are claiming that yes, he needs these guns, and because he has not only divine identity, they call it alaukik, but he's also laukik, he has a bodily identity, and his bodily identity must be protected. This bodily identity is eating, having children, and so on. Yeah, but after all, do we not all have, at least religious people believe that we have body and soul. So can we not all argument with the same way that our soul is holy and non-violent, but of course, come on, my body needs to do some violence because I need to rape that woman because my body needed some sex, or I need to kill those 10 people because actually they are quite rich and I need their money, my body needs their money. So as soon as you start to argument with the fact that the bodily needs of a divine avatar should be taken separating like his divine teaching of his soul, divine soul. So then there is no limit to the crimes that he's allowed to do in the name of being an avatar.